Thank you also, Your Excellencies. Let's welcome Senator Samuel Anyanwu from Imo State representing Owerri Senatorial Zone. We want to welcome you.
Somebody here won't let it change.
Distinguished Senator Chukwuka Utazi representing Enugu North Senatorial Zone. We are
number 10, no, you say she has a. I ain't got a man down for
Sidney Keshuku, member, Federal House of Representatives, representing Aniri Ogo, Oji River Federal Constituency. We'll come back to this for the recognitions. Your Excellencies, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, and in general, permit me to welcome distinguished Senator Eninaya Abaribe, distinguished Senator Eninaya Abaribe,
Alasala,
the Chairman Senate Committee, Chairman on Power, and the leader of the Southeast Caucus of the Senate of the National Assembly. Forward with him is also
Key,
distinguished Senator
Key.
I know distinguished Senator Victor Mink. You can also see Right Honorable Rita Madabu, the Speaker of Anambra State Assembly, and a good number of honorable members.
Chukwu is already here, and all the members of the National Assembly should be here. The Speaker, Abia State House of Assembly, we welcome you as well. We shall now hand over the microphone to the Southeast leader, the leader of the Southeast Caucus, the Chairman, Southeast Caucus, at the National Assembly, distinguished Senator Eninaya Abaribe. We now hear.
Alasala, 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 number two, no, Ise, Ishi, Asa. Anyagana, Mananda, Kwasiri, Keno, Ice.
Chairman of this occasion, Ahejagam Bandibo. Your Excellencies, the Deputy Senate President, who at this moment is supporting his leader in the National Assembly.
Yes.
Your Excellency Governor William Obiano of Anambra State, and all the distinguished guests that have come here, we are going to do two things. The first one is to adopt the communique, the summit communique as read by the erudite Professor Charles Soludo, and I have the singular honor and privilege to move that this solemn assembly do adopt everything that is put in that document as a working tool for us to use in restructuring Nigeria. I so move.
Mindful of the work that has been done by the committee set up for this summit, and realizing that they carry the will of our people, I want to solemnly second the motion that been moved by the National Assembly Caucus leader. I so support.
So we now ask the Speaker of the House of Assembly of Anambra State. We will use you as a point of contact for all the speakers of the Southeast State to put the question. Madam Speaker.
Yeah, thank you. Good. Those in support that this House will adopt all the recommendations by the chairman of this planning summit, in the person of Professor Chukwuma Soludo, say aye.
Aye.
Those again, say nay.
They're not here.
The ayes have it.
Oh, yes.
And so we can now move on to the second thing, which is to reassure everybody here, especially our friends that have come from far to be with us here, that we in the National Assembly, cognizant that we will need to move very quickly on this motion, will go back and do the needful by quickly bringing forth a bill to set up a constituent assembly for getting a new constitution of Nigeria based on peace, equity, justice, and fair play. That is what we promise you, and all my colleagues here at the National Assembly, led by our very, very good and dear Iko Handi Bonile, will do whatever we can to bring this to book, to bear. And I want to reassure everybody that this we shall do. Secondly, we want to also say this. We don't want to live in a Nigeria where those that go around and kill people every day, the federal government finds it very, very difficult to declare them a terrorist group. And we now ask that the terrorist caption that has been put on our brothers in IPOB, who never killed a single person, be hereby rescinded. And we want to now ask everybody to please listen to our dear Deputy Senate President.
The chairman of this important summit, Ahadjemba, Chief Iwanyam, will salute you. We recognize the President General of Ahanese, Chief Nyamwodo. We recognize your Royal Highnesses here present, our brothers and sisters from different parts of Nigeria who are here to show support and solidarity to our people. We recognize in particular the host governor, the governor of Anambra State, for providing this environment and making today possible. First, let me say that I stand by my colleagues from the Southeast in the National Assembly and State Assemblies in adopting the position of Ndibo on restructuring. Let me add that we're not alone. We have people from other parts of Nigeria who have seen the reason and the need for us to reflect on the journey so far and be able to adjust our movement to enable us arrive at our destination. So today is a very historic day in Nigeria that we've made a very historic move to move our country forward and be able to stop the killings going on by providing the necessary security architecture in a federal system such as ours. We believe that the resources we have in Nigeria is sufficient to make Nigeria the greatest nation in Africa if we restructure and take advantage of the solid minerals in the north and the agricultural potentials and oil and gas in the south and the human resources all over. We want to thank Nigerians that have shown solidarity to our people in times of our neglect, especially in the last constitutional conference where it was agreed that the Southeast require an additional state. I'm happy that most of you are here today to show that you still stand by us. In the next week or two, in the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Southeast Development Commission bill will definitely be passed by the grace of God. Let me also add that in furtherance of what's been agreed today, that we in the National Assembly will continue to network with our brothers and sisters of other parts of Nigeria in order to arrive at sufficient consensus on the issue of restructuring. No part of Nigeria can go it alone. We need to talk to ourselves, we need to network, we need to explain. We need to carry everybody along in this exercise and let them understand that it's the best for everybody. It is a win-win situation. I would like to call on our leaders from different parts of Nigeria to engage those who are not sufficiently convinced on this enterprise that Nigeria will be better and greater for everybody if we restructure our country. And I would like to commit myself to the fact that once the bills for restructuring are produced, that I, Senator Ike Okwuemadu, will be the lead sponsor of those bills. I know, and I'll keep in mind of my colleagues here, that they'll all be good sponsors. We have our colleagues from the Northeast, the Northwest, North Central, the Southwest, South South, and other indigenous and citizens of Nigeria in various states who are indeed eager to support these bills to see a better Nigeria for our people and for our future. So we thank all of you for this opportunity and let the struggle continue. Let this determination never cease. Let us march on. Nigeria indeed will be greater. God bless you all.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, Iko.
And how felt the solutions by the Ndibo? What effect?